Well, I have a few chargers that need to be repaired. We're going to start with this Turnigy EcuCell 6. This one actually has a really weird issue. If you do charge, as you can see, it works just fine. Okay. But if you go balance, you get an input error. Which is weird because this power supply is more than adequate. I mean, any other. This has been used on this power supply for a while, so. So you can see that error there. But if you try discharge, that also works fine. So it's like the balance circuit is fried or has an issue. So we're going to open it up and see what we can find, because honestly I need the balance function for it to work properly, and I have a few other ones I have to look at. Well, I found the error. It is the in-channel MOSFET closest to the power supply, which is right there. It doesn't show any scorch marks or anything, but when I took the meter to all of them, this one here, the discharge FET, this one, they all didn't make a tone, but this one toned out, so this one's probably bad, but it's probably shorted to the point where the charger still works through it. But it's not, there's the signal wire that's not, it's not getting that, so when it goes into charge mode or balance mode, it doesn't detect the voltage coming from the jack, so it gives me a volt error. So that's definitely the one that's, the issue. Obviously I don't have that, so, but I do have a different casing of it. I got ones that are like that. So I might modify that and just have it sitting there, just to get it up and running, see if it works. Well, not the best setup there, but this is just a quick test just to see if the FET works. And let's power it up. Well, it's a good sign. At least it turns on. Let's do a quick. Okay, well, that's the one I used. And this is the original one there. There's the FET there. We got it powered up here. So let's see, we do the charge first. No problem there. No volt error. It's not getting even warm. Okay, it's the balance that was the issue. Wow. I fixed it. So if you see this error, and I basically showed you where, how you can quickly fix it. So it didn't take much. I'll desolder this and make it a little bit neater, like in the bottom. That's there where the it doesn't have to be heat sink. It's not not even getting warm. So, but it's back from the dead. I hope somebody can use this video. They have one with the same error. Mind you, that error could also be the fact that your power supply is not good enough for your charger. But if you've been using it on a charger for a while, like I have been using this charger all summer and I have no issues with it, and then all of a sudden the charger goes bad and starts giving you a volt error, you know why. It's that FET. And she's up and running. So we'll put it back together and let it run for a while, just to be sure. You know what, it might actually be alright like that. It might not hit the casing. If I could, I would leave it like that. Just so standing up and it'll cool better. The air going through it. But, as you can see, I'm having zero issues with it, so that's fixed it. It'll fit. Later. Well, I couldn't get it to fit up here, so what I did is I ran extra leads and I tucked it underneath and isolated it from the bore, from the casing. So it'll, if it does get warm, it'll conduct heat to the heat sink. Just about to do a test here, just to make sure she's good to go. Would air it out by now. Let's try it at 6 or 5. Oh, it goes to 6. No airs. No heat. Sweet.